Alright, back to work. So, welcome back. Time to give you a traditional CTO Larsson market update. I've been looking forward to this. There hasn't been that much to talk about in the markets, but now is the time to start paying attention. As you know, Bitcoin has moved into this range. And Bitcoin is really the clue to everything here. All other coins are just following Bitcoin at this point. So regardless what coin you're interested in, we got to understand what is happening with Bitcoin. And we're at a critical point right now. And if we zoom in a little bit here, perhaps you saw my posts that Larsson line flipped blue around here at little over 49,000. And then we have this line here. If you follow me for some time, you remember this line here. It's been here for over half a year. And now we got near perfect touch on that 4,600 line. So is this the reversal that we have been hoping for? Well, we have to see it like this. We don't know yet. The selling pressure has been fairly constant. There hasn't been a blow-off panic capitulation selling yet. It has been constant sell pressure. And of course, now we have hit a solid support line, and that could be a logical point for the market to turn. But we don't know that yet. Larsson line is down. There has not been a bottom formation in the chart, and we have not had capitulation volume. We shall look at that in a second. But still, buying a solid support line with a stop loss sufficiently below is never a wrong strategy. And if it breaks, okay, then we cut that position. Then the next attempt to get in will be around the 30k support. As I'm recording this, you can see that there is purchase interest. These wicks down have all been bought up fairly quickly, but we don't know yet how much sell pressure there is left. Capitulation volume means that there's an avalanche of selling. Price goes down, people panic sell, and huge amounts of coins are transferring hands. That's what capitulation volume means, and that often happens at the major reversal. We see this best on the weekly chart. If we look here 2018, this reversal, this bottom here in November 2018, here was panic buying at that week. That's where it reversed. Here we have capitulation selling on this bottom. And here in May 2021, we had capitulation volume on this bottom where the reversal started. But where is the capitulation volume on the current dip? It is nowhere to be found. Not on this exchange, not on other exchanges. So that is one reason that we can't be too sure that this is the reversal. Of course, it's possible. I'd say even that it's a decent risk reward here. But we cannot know for sure. We need some confirmation. We need a bottom pattern, or we need capitulation volume. Let's continue looking at the other coins. Ethereum to BTC moved into this beautiful range between 0.055 and the 0.08 region. Then we had the breakout here in early December 2021, and at least I was excited. But sadly, this breakout failed, and we're now back into the range. Analyzing the altcoins against the US dollar is pretty difficult, because most of them, they just follow Bitcoin at this point to some extent. And I find it easier to analyze the relative strength of the altcoin to BTC in this particular market. Having said that, no harm in looking at the ETH to USD chart as well. So let's do that. From May 2020 to May 2021, we had this beautiful parabola that was very easy to trade. Larsson line gold, and then we had parabola break, and Larsson line blue flip shortly after. We could also have drawn this curve something like this, which also would have great many touch points. Here, 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 here. But even if we draw it like that, that parabola is broken too. And as you can maybe see here, Larsson line has turned blue on Ethereum to USD. And it turned blue at about $3,800 on January 3rd, 2022. And then we got this drop to approximately this level at 2,900, which stems from this resistance flipped support going back to May 2021. And if this doesn't hold here, it's not good. We have a parabola break, we have Larsson line blue flip. If this support doesn't hold, well, that's a bit worrying if you're trading ETH versus USD. And I have exposure like that through my ISK, so I'm not so happy to see this. BNB is another major coin that we analyzed a lot on this channel. As you recall, we had this beautiful run-up, then we had consolidation on this support, and then we had kind of a breakout here in December 2021. And that support is just about holding right now. Let's zoom in a little bit. We can see that it's this resistance here that flipped support and just about holding now. Should this one break, there's potential further downside on the BNB to BTC chart. But for now, it's holding. Another coin I've talked quite a lot about is the Solana to BTC. And full disclosure, I hold exposure to Bitcoin, Ethereum and Solana in ISK through my bank. Solana had this beautiful run-up. And then we've gotten a very clean range consolidation here. From 0.0033 to 0.0042 approximately. Now we're just at the bottom of that range boundary. If this holds here and makes another breakout, that will be a very strong sign for bullish continuation. This parabola broke, but so far there has not been any signs of a downwards move from here. And again, I think the Solana to BTC chart is better to analyze, but no harm looking at the USD chart as well. And as you can see here, it has charted very well. We had Larsson line blue here, then the parabola started, there it ran up here, parabola broke. Larsson line flipped blue, but the coin recovered. We got a new parabola that ran up here. And now Larsson line against the dollar has flipped blue. We will have to see how this plays out. Now I will show another chart that I have not discussed on this channel before. It's a tip from Peter Brandt, the legend, the man himself. I just modified it a little bit and flipped it around, and I think it's very interesting. So this is Solana divided by ETH. So up means Solana strength, down means Ethereum strength versus Solana. And as you can see, this has trended very, very well. We had an upwards trend, we had a strong downwards trend here, Larsson line blue, then it turned around approximately here. This formed a clear bottom formation, inverse head and shoulder. We were trending up, trending up, trending up. Then we got a clean symmetrical triangle. Just as it started looking a little bad, this one broke up again, Larsson line gold again. We ran up again, and now we're in another symmetrical triangle. Depending on which direction this breaks out, we will get another clue if Ethereum will regain some strength against Solana or if Solana might go for another leg up against Ethereum in this direction. And as you can see, these moves here are pretty significant. These are not small moves if you look here on the side where you see the scale. So this we're going to track on the channel. By the way, if you haven't subscribed, make sure to do so now. Then I will share something else which I think is very interesting. And that is Bitcoin dominance. Look how clean this 40% support level has been. And are we maybe getting another bounce off the 40% dominance? So this means that if it bounces again, Bitcoin is taking back the leadership flag from the alts. And what I hope to see as a crypto bull is that Bitcoin dominance start leading the way again. That it's Bitcoin that's driving the market and we get an increasing percentage Bitcoin dominance at the same time as this 40K support level holds against the dollar and we start getting a run back up like this. That would be very strong if Bitcoin as the locomotive of this market starts driving the market forward, then funds are going to spill over into the alts and we could get a very healthy market again. But again, we don't know that yet. Hope is not a strategy. Hope is not part of my trading process at least. We have to monitor for a solid bottom construction in the Bitcoin chart especially. Nothing else matters at this point. Will 40K hold or will we have to try to redo our entry at 30K instead? I think that the next few days will be revealing for this market. It's time to pay attention again. No more holidays. Now it's back to work. CTO Larsson out. Please like, subscribe, and see you soon. Hejdå!